Hi, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Happy Veterans Day. You know, Veterans Day is tomorrow. A lot of people had today off. And it was really crowded outside and freezing today. And since we are celebrating Veterans Day, I decided to wear my t-shirt. Da, da, da. See? USA, USA. Now, as far as the ball players kneeling, they have every right. It doesn't matter to me because we all know the Star Spangled Banner, what it means. If you don't know by now, them doing their kneeling will certainly have you look it up. So, you know, listen, we live in a country where people run over here to be because, you know, if they did anything, they'd have their knees cut off. If they kneeled, they stole something, their hands would be cut off. You know, if they lied, their tongue would be pulled out. So, hey, listen, you know, and I don't think it's anything against the vets. I mean, they went out and fought. That doesn't change anything. Our love for the vets will never, ever cease, even though this country, when Vietnam vets came back, didn't show a whole lot of love. I don't know. We always have a tendency to talk out of both sides of our necks, if you understand what I'm saying. You know, we say one thing, we do another. We got homeless vets. We don't give them the services. Anytime there's a budget in this country, we cut everything that has to do with helping the people that need to be helped. It's just really a very selfish, self-centered, self-absorbed country. And a lot of people come over here because they want that same kind of greed. You know, they want to make a better life for themselves. But if you really look at America and you're from another country and you say, well, wait a minute, how come they still have their own people sleeping on the street? Why haven't they helped their own people? What makes them think they're gonna help me? Well, I guess they do. I don't know. Anyway, the reason I'm playing My Love is Free by Double Exposure is because one of the questions that somebody asked me, and then I'll probably come back to all the other stuff, is would I ever marry again? So we're going to get to that in a minute, but in the meantime, hold your horses. Okay. So there is so much going on in the news when it comes to men and their penises and these, you know, Hollywood and, you know, oh, this one touched me, this one. And it don't matter if you're a male, a female, a boy, a girl, you know, a big, strong, blossom man. What's that guy's name that used to play the father on Everybody Hates Chris? I'm really bad with names, but even he had his groin grab. I mean, what is it? It's everything. Are people just walking penises, you know, with feet? You know, are people, you know, and, you know, I don't know what's happening. I don't. And this has been going on for a long time. So now you got everybody in the woodworks coming out, you know, but yet, you know, no disrespect, but a lot of these people have gotten to where they are because they sold their souls to the devil. And let's just, you know, lots of people sell their souls to the devil. The devil's not a person, you know, but lots of people sell their souls to get whatever it is that they want. You know, they'll have family members killed. They'll do whatever they have to do. And that's really a shame. Politics, celebrity, movie stars, rock stars. Anybody who wants to be famous, all they got to do, because there's always a spirit around working for the other side that will be able to get you everything you want, if you so choose to. I suggest you don't. I'm just saying, I've heard stories. I've heard stories. But at any rate, I think it's a shame because every time you turn on the news, I don't even watch it anymore because I know somebody else has been sexually molested 100 years ago. Now they're going to press charges. Now the person can't make the movie anymore. They're going to take the movie out, substitute somebody else. I mean, it's never, ever ending. That seems to be the only thing that's in the news lately. You know, between, you know, I guess Donald Trump going to he's in Vietnam now. I guess he was in Japan and his little granddaughter sang, you know, a song in Japanese because she's being taught Mandarin. just between me and you, you know the language that's most spoken is Chinese, right? So I know a lot of people say, oh, Hispanic, Spanish, Spanish. Well, yeah, it's Spanish if you're going to do customer service. It's Spanish if you're working for the Department of Social Services. It's Spanish if you, but most, you know, people, it's Mandarin. It's Chinese because there's a billion of them, you know. I mean, you know, the Hispanics would have to have a whole heap of sex just to get caught up. I mean, they had to stop people from having babies because there was, first of all, the population of this land is already too much, you know. So people who want to have 9 and 10 babies, listen, I said to stop it too. I thought 2 was enough. And I think anybody should stop it too. I mean, I'm not trying to tell, but they are expensive. Hello, you got to buy food for these people, clothes for these people. And they're outgrowing them like every 2 weeks. I'm just saying. Anyway, so the question that was posed to a viewer who always watches, hi, would I ever get married again? Well, I wasn't planning on getting married the first time, by the way, but and that was a time when I really didn't want to have children, but then I fell in love with this little boy who had a twin sister, and he had cancer, and, you know, he died, but I loved him so much, and I kept saying, I want one of these, and also my nephew, who I just kept saying, oh my God, I could have 10 of these. He was killed in a car accident, my sister and my brother-in-law, and that was very, very sad. My Spencer, who's in heaven, he's just a little angel watching down on all of us. Anyway, would I get married again? You know, it's a tough question because I'm a real old-fashioned Southern girl and men just don't respect that kind of thing anymore. You know, I mean, I like to cook. You know, if I had a bigger house, it would be, you know, neater. I like to do things. I like to make sure that my partner is always happy. But you can't. It's very difficult to find a person who loves you as much as you love them. They don't exist. Men are very much into themselves, you know. I mean, I'm not saying there aren't good ones out there, but they're very much into themselves, you know, and doing what they want to do. You know, I don't think a lot of guys are going to, at least the ones that are single, the ones that are married, they know they have to do. Most of my male friends are just fabulous. You know, their wives are wonderful. They're wonderful. They know they have to sacrifice. That's what a relationship is about, sacrificing. You have to sacrifice something that you like and that you love in order to make that other person happy. And if you're not willing to sacrifice anything, if you're not willing to give up anything, at least for a minute, then you're probably not going to be the right person. So I enjoy, you know, making a partner happy. You know, I enjoy, you know, cooking. I enjoy making things nice and neat. And I enjoy just doing for the person. I was with this one guy. He was very professional, you know, always wore a suit and tie, very tall, very handsome. You know, play basketball and always wanted me to come to the game. Ivy, you're my good luck charm. You got to come with me. I would come and watch him play basketball. And when he'd come back, you know, I'd get a pail of hot soapy water and take his sneakers and his socks off and, you know, put his feet in and massage his feet. And I flossed his teeth. I drew his bath water. All the other wives and girlfriends used to say, Ivy, you got to stop because, you know, our men are expecting us to treat them the way that you treat him. And so, you know, I don't know. But he did things for me too. It's just that when certain things come into play, you know, I won't even talk about that. But I'm just really old fashioned and I just really believe in, you know, doing unto others as you would have them do unto you. And most men are not going to try to sacrifice. They want somebody to cook and clean for them. But you also have to cook and clean yourself. And this guy that I was talking about used to give me money on the weekends, tell me, go get my hair done, go get my nails done so we can look good. He was doing the cleaning at the house because he's a firstborn son and the only son who had younger sisters. And I think depending on where you play in the where you are sibling wise, I think makes a big difference on your relationship. At least to me, it does. You know, I've gone out with guys who are firstborn. They're always neat, you know, always clean, always tidy. you know, real good workers, you know, really caring about women. Like, they don't care if they go and get your feminine hygiene stuff. You know, they're not embarrassed. They're in touch with their feminine part. They know that everybody at the store knows it's not for them. So they either have a wife or they have a daughter, you know, so, or girlfriend or whatever. So, you know, I mean, I'm very happy with knowing guys like that and knowing that they exist. But if a guy is into sports or into music, you know, and they're in the band, they're not going to sacrifice anything for you. You know, you get sick, you know, as you all get older, you know, and this person's still, you know, wishing that they could play, you know, basketball and still gazing at the game or on their phone or, you know, playing their music. They're not going to sacrifice for you. I mean, you could think that they will, but more than likely, they're just not going to do it. You can be home cooking a dinner and waiting for them to come. They're not going to come. At least that's been my experience. So would I get married again? It would have to be someone who is stable, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, knows to put God first, but not so much to the extreme that they're a fanatic, takes care of themselves. I like someone who likes to keep their body in shape because it'll help me get back in shape because I'm not as in shape as I should. By the way, you guys, I have to lose 30 pounds. I'm not even really, I mean, I don't think I have to lose 30 pounds, but I do have to lose 30 pounds because I have an irregular heartbeat. And so I used to have these fabulous arms. Look, I'm trying to get out of this stuff, but I need to lose weight. You know, I gained a lot, so it is what it is. I'm a petite girl, so I like to be petite. I need to get back to a healthier size. Anyway, so I'm going to start working out. I'm going to try to get a Fitbit or some kind of thing where I can, you know, clock my heart rate and all that other kind of stuff. So I think it's very important when women are going to choose a guy to be with that they need to choose someone who is going to treat them like a queen, you know, and he'll be treated like a king. You know, it's a give and take. I like the song by and I don't have it on my playlist, but the song by Teddy Pendergrass, "It Feels So Good Loving Somebody When Somebody Loves You Back." It's a wonderful thing. But, you know, can you get someone to love you as much as you love them? Probably. I guess I need to get out more, you know, working on all this stuff that I have to work on keeps me from going places. But you know what? I figured eventually I'm going to get out, you know, and, you know, really, I'm not looking for anybody. I like being single right now because I've always been in relationships, you know, from the time I was, you know, in my teens, you know, and they've always been long-term relationships. Nothing has usually been less than 4 years, you know. I spent a lot of time with people, you know. Once you go black, you never go back. No, I don't cross the line. Not that I have anything, but I don't date people from other cultures. I don't date, you know, people from other races. It's hard enough trying to deal with people from my own race and my own ethnicity. Communication is key to me. So sometimes if people don't understand things, I also like the guys to have manners. I'm old fashioned. You know, I don't think that women should be belching and burping all loud and passing gas. And I mean, I guess that'll happen eventually as you be with the person. But I'm thinking like maybe for the first 6 months to a year, you're probably not going to. I'm sure they know that you do. But I don't know. You know, I think they can see you without makeup. You know, that's fine. I like being natural. The most that I put on is lipstick and a little eyeliner. Even though I think today, I decided because it's, do I still have any on? I decided to put on some blue. Can you see my blue? My eyelids. I put on some blue sparkles for my red, white, and blue for my t-shirt. So anyway, let me go. I have so much to do. I'm so depressed. Do I seem depressed? I'm really depressed. I'm not really depressed, but yesterday in court was a trip. But that's okay, because I'm going to come back with a vengeance, okay? Because I know my God is going to take care of everything. I don't know how anybody lives without God, because he keeps the inner peace. You just have to know that regardless of what Mr. Charlie and Miss Loretta is trying to do to you, and you know they get together and they're not about you, because they see you a certain way. You know, they see you as a shenanay, shaking your head and rolling your neck and everything. So they don't respect you. You're a waste of their time. They don't even want you in court because they just feel like you're a thorn in their side. You know, how dare you fight for yourself? You know, you little N, you know, and I'm sure he wanted to call me an N, you know, but you know, he held it together, but I remember and I know. So it's not easy, but you all pray for me. Really pray for me. Pray that God will give me the strength. I'm going to go through this no matter what. Okay. So I'll let you know what's happening. Thank you all so much for listening. I hope I haven't been rambling on, but I am really tired. And this thing's probably taking pictures of me looking all kinds of ways, but that's okay. Anyway, I had to put my hair up. See my bun? I had to put my bun up because it is cold outside and these girls were going into some kind of shock maniac, like, first it's hot and then it's cold. What are we doing? You know, so I have to put them up to kind of protect them a little bit. You know, I need to take better care, but I'm going to do that. I promise I'm going to do that. You guys are going to see a whole new me. By the time April comes around, I'm going to be 20 pounds lighter. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I say I'm going to do it. Don't hold me to it, but I'm going to try. All right. Listen, you guys. By the way, what's the song? My Love is Free. Okay. Let me find the one that I want to end this with, okay? And we'll see. Okay, this is the one that I need to be saying. Because sometimes guys will say they're free and they ain't. You don't know what the heck they doing. And sometimes you don't know if they really like women or if they like men. So there's songs about men being with men being with other women. Oh my God. This whole dating thing is and I'm not even dating. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just, you know, I just have friends. Say, listen, I'm a tomboy. My brother and I are twins, so you know, men to me are just, they're always interesting. I've been on out here on my own. I ain't afraid to live alone. Anyway, like the show. It's a long one, man. I'm so sorry, but I had a good time talking to you guys. Anyway, it makes me feel better. Anyway, like the show. Subscribe, please. All right. Are you free? Come on now. Can you stay all night? All right. Goodbye.